In Figma, you can now select and edit objects in bulk across multiple frames. You can change multiple text elements at the same time. You can apply individual transformations at the same time. You can change objects inside auto layout frames and even inside component variants, you guessed it, at the same time. All of this and more is possible thanks to the multi-edit feature. It's recently been reworked into something amazing, and I'm gonna tell you all about it in this video. Hey, I'm Adi, and without further ado, let's get straight into the basics. This video is brought to you by Envato Elements, the largest unlimited creative subscription in the world. Click the link in the description to find out more. So let's start from the beginning. I have three frames here, and each contains the same elements. Now, if I want to select, for example, this first rectangle, what I would do is I would click it, and then I will hold down Shift, and I would click on the others. But now with multi-edit, there is a faster way. So what you do is you select the element that you want to multi-edit, and then you go to the toolbar where we have a new button that's called Select Matching Layers. You can also see the keyboard shortcut there, Control-Alt-A on Windows, and it's Command-Option-A on macOS. So when I do that, click, and it automatically selects my other matching layers from the other frames. And I can, you know, do the same for any of my layers. As long as that element is present in other frames, it's going to be automatically selected, just like that. Now, how exactly does Figma know what elements to select? Well, it looks at the layer name and position. So this layer is called blue rectangle. This one is also blue rectangle, as is this. But these are also called blue rectangle. But as you can see, if I select this first one, and then I select all the matching layers, Figma just selects the first layer from the other two frames. The first layer, which is called the same, right? Blue rectangle. If I were to rename this to blue rectangle one, and I select this, and I do the same thing, this gets omitted. It selects this one, and it selects this one, the next on the list. That's a really, really cool behavior. Now, apart from clicking the button on the toolbar or using the keyboard shortcut, you can hold down Shift, and Figma will do hinting. So notice how it drew a blue outline around the matching elements, right? So when I hold down Shift, it shows me what elements are matching whatever I have selected. So then what I can do is I can click and drag with my mouse, and it's just going to select the elements that were hinted. And you can also select multiple elements, by the way. If I just want to select the green and red elements, I hold down Shift, it highlights them for me in these other two frames, and I can, you know, drag to select whatever I want. Just be careful not to click inside the frame, right? So let's do that again. So Shift, if I click outside of the frame and I click and drag, it just selects the matching layers. But if I click inside frame, it you know, it acts like just a regular Shift click and drag. It selects every other element. Finally, the last thing you need to remember is that you can use sections in Figma to scope the grouping of frames. So what does that mean? First of all, a section, this is a section right here. You can create one by going to the toolbar here and selecting the section tool. A section is basically a way to group multiple frames in your canvas. Now, if I were to zoom out here, you'll see that I have two sections, and they each contain the exact same elements. So if I were to select this blue rectangle again and select all the matching layers, you'll notice it only selects the ones from its corresponding section, not the ones from here. So that's what I mean by, you know, scoping. When you create a section, you create a scope, you create a context, right? And multi-edit will only work within that context. It will not look outside of the section. Now, among other things, multi-edit allows you to change text elements really easily. In this example, I have three frames, and each one contains the same text elements. So what we can do is we can select a piece of text, go to the toolbar, select all the matching layers, and now I have an additional option in the toolbar called multi-edit text. So I can click that, or I can hit enter, and that's gonna enter edit mode. So now I can type in the new text, and it's gonna update on all the matching text layers. Let's do that again here. Select this bit, select the matching layers, and alternatively, you know, I can press T to grab the text tool, and I can click on any of these text elements, and I can edit that just as a normal text, but while multi-edit is still active, all the other text elements that were selected are being edited. Now, multi-edit works great when it comes to object alignment. In this example, let's select these first two elements. As usual, we're gonna select all the matching layers from the other frames. And now you'll notice that when I change the alignment, let's say align right, that alignment will apply to each selection individually. Figma will not just take all six elements and align them all to the right side. It's going to apply that alignment individually to each selection, which is super, super cool. I can align them to the left, to the middle, and so on. Maybe I want to select these from all of the frames. Maybe I want to align these at the bottom. Now, here's another cool feature when it comes to alignment. Let's say you want to align all of these to the right side of the frame. You saw that if you select these and you apply a transformation and you set an alignment property, it applies that alignment to the objects themselves. But if you want to apply the alignment in relation to the parent frame, here's what you do. You hover your mouse cursor over the alignment options and you press Shift. You see how the icons change? By holding down Shift, you can access the align to frame alignment options. So I can align them to the middle, to the right, to the top, to the bottom, whatever I want. So it takes the whole selection and it aligns it to the frame instead of to themselves. Super, super cool feature. Just remember, hold down Shift. Recently, I needed an eye-catching intro for one of my videos, but video editing is not my strong suit. So I turned to Envato Elements for a creative boost. For the first 10 seconds of this project, I used these two video titles along with these two geometric backgrounds. I imported everything in DaVinci Resolve, made a few adjustments to the text, and done. The result? A vibrant, eye-catching intro that sets the tone for the rest of the video. Now, I'm no Spielberg, but I love the end result, so I would highly recommend Envato Elements. Huge library of assets, one subscription, and unlimited downloads. For more info, check out the links in the video description. One of the most common operations you'll do in Figma is to transform objects. And when you pair this with multi-edit, you'll find that it's a really big time saver. So let's select this pink rectangle, select all the other matching layers. And now you'll see that when we apply a transformation to it, meaning we move it up or down, all of the items change. When we rotate it, it rotates each individual item of that selection. We can make it bigger or smaller, and it's going to apply the transformation individually to each matching layer. Now, if we take a look at the blue rectangle, you'll see that in the first frame, it has a rotation of 0. In the second frame, 30 degrees, and minus 30 degrees in the third frame. Now, if I'm going to select all the matching layers, and Figma does this without a problem, even though these have different transformations applied to them, you'll see that when I start transforming one of them, the others will transform as well, but they will transform relative to their initial position. So they don't just default to, let's say, 0 degrees. This one starts at 0 degrees, but this one starts at 30 degrees. So, you know, they will transform relatively to the existing properties, which is super cool. And if at some point I want to maybe rotate all of these by the same amount, but in the inspector it says mixed, I can do something like this, plus 30. And that's going to add 30 degrees to each one of these. So now this will be at 60 degrees, this will be at 30, this will be at 0. The same thing goes for, you know, scaling or changing dimensions. If I select the orange circles, you'll see that each one has a different size. But when I change their size, I do that relatively to their default size. And by the way, scaling works here as well. If I press K, I can do the same. I can make these twice as big if I want to. Now, let's talk about auto layout, because multi-edit works great with it. Now, let me give you a little bit of context. In the past, before this feature was reworked, if I were to select all of these elements and I would add auto layout, Figma will put all of them in one frame with auto layout. But with multi-edit, this is now a different story. So I can select all of these. I can select all the matching layers. And now if I press Shift A, or if I go in here and I add auto layout, Figma will do that, will apply auto layout to every single selection individually, right? So it creates an auto layout frame with these elements, and then another one with these elements, and another one with these elements. Fantastic. And then, you know, I can change maybe the direction here. And then another cool feature, if I select the pink rectangle from all the other frames, I can use the up and down arrow keys to change its position, and where it's applicable, Figma will change the position of that element. So here I have an auto layout frame that's set to wrapping, so I can use the up and down arrow keys, and I can also use the left and right arrow keys. This will work in horizontal layouts, but also in layouts with wrapping, because those go in two directions. And I can do that for any element that I want. Finally, let's talk about components, because when it comes to multi-edit, there are some really cool changes. So in here, I have three frames, each containing the same button element. Now, let's say this is a bigger project and I want to turn this button into a component that I can later reuse. So normally what I would do is I would select one of these elements. I would turn it into a component, and then I would get some instances to copy in the other frames, but not with multi-edit. You see, now you can select this element, you can then select the matching layers, and then you can hit the Create Component button. And that does two things. First of all, it creates the button component for me, it pushes it outside of those frames, and this is the main component, right? And it then replaces the other three elements with instances of this component. just with the click of a button. How easy is that? And there's actually more changes when it comes to components. Let's say I want to create a variant or multiple variants for this button. So I can click the add variant button there, and I can click the add variant button there as well. So now I have three variants. And let's say I want to change the text on all of them. So what I can do is I can select one of the variants and I can go in here and I can click a multi-edit variants or press Q on the keyboard. That's going to select all the other matching variants. So now I can go in here and I can change the text to send my message, for example. Or maybe I want to change the background color. I can do that really easily. Or maybe I want to add an icon to this. So with multi-editing still active, which by the way, you can press Q at any time to stop or start multi-editing, I can go into my components here and I can grab an icon, and that's going to place it in all the variants at the same time. And then of course you would go ahead and make your individual changes for each variant. It really depends on what you're creating that variant for. And of course, because I worked on the main component, all the other instances that I created earlier, or rather that Figma created earlier for me, are now updated. And that was a super quick look at Figma multi-edit. What do you think about this new feature? Let us know down in the comments. As always, don't forget to check out the Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel for more content like this, but also to learn about web design, web development, and much more. It's all free, so make sure you hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. I'm Adi, thank you very much for watching, and until next time,